Hi everyone, welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. Today we'll be looking at the new Skydome feature that has been just added in Twinmotion 2022. To access that feature, it's pretty simple. I will come to Settings, Lighting. And here we have an option Skydome on off. Here is the sky, the default sky that you have inside Twinmotion. That sky is dynamic. So for example, here if I go to the Settings, Weather. If I start to raise, for example, the weather, you have some clouds that start to appear. The problem with those clouds is they are not photorealistic. It's created by the computer. It's dynamic, so that means that clouds will get bigger and after that it will start to rain. But again, the problem is not at the quality of what we want to achieve with some image that we want to generate with Twinmotion. So now if you come to the Settings, Lighting, Skydome, when you turn that option on, it will replace the Twinmotion sky by an HDRI texture, which is a photo, so it's photorealistic. Twinmotion also ships with hundreds of HDRI textures. You can find them in the library. Here you have the new Skydome folder. It's divided in basically time of day. So we have the low sun, which is the start and the end of the day. We have the morning and the afternoon, so the sun is a bit higher in the sky. And we finally have the noon. By default, the first sky, when you turn that option on, is the noon clear 01, as you can see in the dock. So you can find it here. It's noon, clear, and it's the first one. As you can see here, when you look at all the different sky, they are not on your disk. So for example, here, if you want to try to drag one in your scene, nothing will happen. As you can see also in the top right corner of the thumbnail, you have a small download icon. So first off, you need to be logged in to be able to download those Skydome. So to do that, I will just come to my burger menu and click on sign in to Epic Games. If you are launching Twinmotion through the Epic Games launcher, you won't need that extra step. So here now I'm logged in, and as you can see here, all the download button appear, and I can now start to download some assets. We do that because we don't want to raise the installation size of Twinmotion. Right now it's around 16 gigabytes. And the size of those HDRI sky is pretty heavy, since we have hundreds and hundreds of them. So now if you want to use a new asset, you will simply need to click on that download button to download the object locally on your machine. So as you can see here, the progress bar will start to progress as it's downloading the asset. Once the asset has been downloaded, you can simply drag and drop it either in the viewport or in that Dropbox. It will transfer, it will convert that texture that has been downloaded into that HDRI texture that Twinmotion can read. And here we have that new sky that has been just switched to the Noon Clear 07. So not a big difference, it's a clear sky. So let's actually have a look at some of the, for example, low sun clear. Now here I can switch, for example, to the low sun clear 3. It has already been downloaded in my scene. So same thing here, just drag and drop in my viewport to add it to my project. So as you can see here, the lighting is way different. We have that low sun, so we have that nice sunset or sunrise that affect my whole project. Now let's have a look at the different options. Here we have the intensity of your Skydome, so you can raise that intensity or lower it. We have the rotation, so you can change the rotation. So as you can see, it changed the rotation of the sky texture, so you see that your sun here is turning, but it also affects the wall lighting of your scene. If you look, for example, at the shadow of the tree here, as you can see, it's turning as the sun turns around the project. Now you can also disable that option. Let's say you want to have that nice lighting as you have over here, but you want to have the sun maybe in front of you. You can disable the match sun and you can now turn that rotation slider to make sure that the sun comes in front of you. So it's not 100% realistic, but it's an option. It's there if you want to use it or not. Let's come back to match sun. So right now here I'm using sky.com from the Twinmotion library. As I told you, there are hundreds of them, but you can also manually import your own sky. To do that, you will simply click on that menu over here and click on open, and you will load your own HDRI texture. So for example, here I have a couple of sky, which is low sun 2, so it will be pretty dark, but I quite like the color of the sky. As you can see here, we have that perfect bluish tint with the nice sun setting down behind those mountains over here. So I quite like that ambience. And here it's just a texture I manually loaded onto my scene. And of course, those HDRI Skydome work with the path tracer, so at any moment you can turn on the path tracer. The lighting is quite different because actually the sun in that specific case is actually hidden behind that mountain. In real time, it's going through that mountain, so that's why you are seeing some sun onto the project. But if you are switching path tracer on, it will be blocked actually by those mountains. But you can also raise the intensity of your Skydome here by playing with that intensity slider. Also, one last thing is that in the properties here, preference, Skydome, here we have two options, the quality of your Skydome in the viewport and the quality at the final export. Basically, each Skydome comes in three different sizes, 2K, 4K, and 8K, which is low, medium, high. I like to leave everything on medium because the quality is already good inside my viewport and also at the final export without overloading my GPU. 8K texture works inside Twinmotion, but it really depends on the size of your project. If you are running some really large project, I highly recommend you stay in medium, which will load the 4K HDRI texture. And that's it for this tutorial. Thank you everyone for joining me. Leave your thoughts in the comments down below and I will see you guys for the next one. Bye everyone!